Good evening, everyone, and Merry Christmas. I want to welcome everyone present here and those on live stream. Before we start, I have a few announcements. Because of the increase in COVID cases, we are encouraging those who can to live stream. If that isn't an option for you, you are welcome to join us here at the church. We are doing our best to love our neighbors as ourselves and to protect our neighbors as ourselves. Tomorrow's Christmas Day service will start at 10:30 a.m. and our Sunday service will start at our regular time at 10:45. Also, our Sunday service will include communion, so we want to take time to prepare our hearts and minds for that. Tonight, we are celebrating a holy night to celebrate Christ's birth. My name is Joan Wilms, and I'll be leading us in worship tonight. Thank you all for coming and joining us tonight. Tonight, we have lit Advent candles, the candle of hope, the candle of love, the candle of joy, and the candle of peace. Tonight, Christmas Eve, we have also lit the Christ candle, which symbolizes the light, along with the hope, love, joy, and peace that Christ brought into the world. Please pray with me as we open our time together. Almighty God, we thank you for the birth of the Christ child in Bethlehem, as announced by the angels on this holy night. May the mystery of the Word made flesh fill our souls with wonder and yearning. Change our hearts from a busy inn into a quiet chamber for your glory. May we who are gathered here or on live stream, join in song with the angels, share the delight of the shepherds, and adore him with the wise men. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Before you came into the sanctuary, you picked up a candle, a little one. If you didn't get one, please raise your hand and an usher will bring one for you. If you are at home, you may want to have a candle handy. These will be used later in the service. They are to remind us of Christ's light that spread through all creation and touched each of us.
Tonight we'll be singing many different Christmas songs. We'll be just going through the service without announcing them, so you can feel free to stay seated while you sing, whether you're at home or here, or stand if you'd like, but that will be up to you. The words will all be on the screen.
Captive Israel that mourns in love.
I'd like to read from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 and 6 and 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them this light has shone. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
From angels bending near the earth.
For a second reading, I would like to read John 1, verses 1 to 5. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of the world. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Sister.
Jesus is the light of the world. Let's think a bit about light. What is it like to be in the dark? Have you ever been someplace really dark? I remember a time we took our children and grandchildren to the Grand Canyon Caverns. And of course, there was light in the caverns. But at one point, they asked us to put our hand in front of our face and they would turn out the lights and to move our hand towards our face. And as soon as we could see our hand, we could stop. Well, it didn't stop until we touched our faces. It was that dark inside, and of course we knew the lights would be turned back on. But if you were in a place where it was suddenly dark, how would you feel? Would it be scary or cold? Would you feel unsure or anxious? Or would you find it boring? What's it like when you or someone else finally flips on a light? Do you feel relief? Relief that you can see? Are you reassured? Things aren't scary anymore. So what does light do? Why is light important? It enables us to see. It lights our way. It brings warmth and comfort. Without it, you're blind, walking in shadow. So where does light come from? And what are some sources of light? Well, we have light bulbs and flashlights. We have flames in candles. We have the sun and the moon. In the passage we read from John 1, Christ is described as the light of the world, shining in the darkness. I wonder what that might mean. How is Christ like light in our dark world? Let's think back to the very beginning of the Bible, Genesis 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And after God made light, God made something else. What was that? People. As the Bible says, "Then God said, let us make mankind in our image, after our likeness." So who carries God's image? All of us carry God's image. However, this image has been broken, and we cannot fix it humanly. This is the good news of Christmas, that Christ's light restores this image as we choose to follow him. Because we follow Christ, his light and love live within us. Scripture tells us to let our lights shine, not to hide them under a bushel. By faith, we have the light of Christ to share, no matter our situation, our health, our age, or our ability. At this point, I'd like us to turn on our candles. How would you like to see more light in your world, in our world? What can we be praying about and asking God together for this very evening, the eve of his birth? Let's pray silently about these hopes and needs for a moment. Lord, in your love and mercy, hear our prayers. Now let's pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Luke 2, verses 1 to 20. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David. He went to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And Mary gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to the shepherds, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to the shepherds, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom God is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And the shepherds went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw the baby, they reported what the angel had said to them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Over the hills and everywhere, go tell it on the mountain that Jesus.
Henry Wadsworth Longfellow wrote this well-known poem in 1864, right in the middle of the Civil War. I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet, the words repeat, of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And thought how, as the day had come, the belfries of all Christendom had rolled along at the unbroken song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then from each dark, accursed mouth, the cannon thundered in the south, and with the sound, the carols drowned of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair, I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then pealed the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail. With peace on earth, goodwill to men. I'd like to share a reading, The Christmas Truth of 1914. On December 7th, 1914, Pope Benedict XV suggested a temporary ceasefire of World War I for the celebration of Christmas. The warring countries refused to create an official ceasefire. But on Christmas, the soldiers in the trenches declared their own unofficial truce. Starting Christmas Eve, Many German and British troops sang Christmas carols to each other across the lines. And at certain points, the Allied soldiers even heard brass bands joining the Germans in their joyous singing. At the first light of dawn on Christmas Day, some German soldiers emerged from their trenches and approached the Allied lines across no man's land, calling out, "Merry Christmas," in English. At first, the Allied soldiers feared it was a trick, but seeing the Germans unarmed, they climbed out of their trenches and shook hands with the German soldiers. The men exchanged presents of cigarettes and plum puddings and sang carols and songs. There was even a documented case of soldiers from opposing sides playing a good-natured game of soccer. The so-called Christmas truce of 1914 came only 5 months after the start of war in Europe and was one of the last examples of chivalry between enemies in warfare. It was never repeated. Officers stopped future attempts at holiday ceasefires with threats of disciplinary action. But it served as heartening proof, however brief, that beneath the brutal clash of weapons, God's gift of peace endured. Imagine how your candlelight would look if it was completely dark in here, and it is pretty dark in here. The light shines even brighter. On this most holy night, long ago in the city of Bethlehem, a Savior who was Christ the Lord was born. Jesus brought his own life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Pastor Gary, please.
What a special evening we've had together to sing hymns and Christmas carols and also read scripture. Thank you for those who have prepared for this. This has been a very special evening. And I'd like to just close with a benediction, if you'd stand with me, and we'll just have a closing benediction, and then we'll sing the favorite Silent Night. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you that we can celebrate your birth many years ago. We thank you that because you have come to this earth, you have given us your faith, you've given us faith, you've given us hope, you've given us peace, and you've given us your love. That is so profound and so deep. And now as we go from here, we pray that we will go with your blessing in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Christmas.